Hey guys, welcome back. So I got my eyebrows microbladed last Tuesday. I believe it was February 2nd. Today is February 11th, so it's been a little bit over a week. I was able to film the procedure, so I wanted to share that with you guys here on YouTube. I did share it in a reel, pretty much the majority of it in a reel on Instagram. So if you're following me on there, you probably saw the gist of what I'm about to share. But in this video, I wanted to go a little bit more in depth on it, answer some questions that I think you might have, and explain the entire procedure for you guys. So with that said, let's get into the video.
Okay, so this is what my brows look like before. You can see some sparse areas there. And the first thing she did was add the topical anesthetic. This is the first one she used. She used two different ones during the entire procedure. And then she went ahead and started to map out the shape of my brows, making sure they were perfect and symmetrical. She used these different tools here, you can see. This is what it looked like a little bit more progressed. You can see that we got a real good shape going on there. And I didn't film it, I guess, but she did use a second topical anesthetic, and that one was supposed to be a little bit stronger before she went in and started to microblade. So this is basically the procedure. You can see it's like a tiny little blade and some ink. So then she just put the ink all over both brows, and we let that sit for a while before she cleaned them off to show me the final result of my brows. She did give me an option to let her know if I wanted to add any more in other places, which was really nice. I did appreciate that. And yeah, this is basically what they look like right after. Did an amazing job. I absolutely love how they turned out.
All right, so that is pretty much the procedure. I will go ahead and answer some questions that I think that you guys might have. These are also questions that people were DMing me on Instagram as well. So I figured they were good questions to answer. So we will answer them here. The most popular question that I was asked was, does it hurt? I'm not gonna say that it doesn't hurt at all. Even with the topical anesthetic, you are gonna feel something, or at least I did feel something. It wasn't like excruciating pain though. Getting a tattoo definitely hurts worse if you've ever gotten a tattoo. And I would say tweezing your eyebrows hurt way worse than getting them microbladed, because she did have to go in and tweeze some things, and that hurt way worse than the microblading procedure. So scale of 1 to 10, I would say like a 1, 2, depending on your pain tolerance. It's not that bad. The next question was, how long do they last? I didn't ask my microblading artist how long it would last. I kind of just went in and did it. But I did look it up online, and it says that it's supposed to last between 6 to 12 months before you really need to like go in and get more done. She did say though that I would have to come in 5 weeks to touch up, because there's like a whole healing process going on within that 5 weeks. She did send me over this chart to put my mind at ease a little bit. I'll go ahead and post it right here for you guys so you guys can see what I'm seeing. So day one, they're gonna look amazing. Day 2 to 5, they're gonna get really dark, which is definitely true. Mine got extremely dark. So yeah, they will get really dark. And then day 5 to 10, they'll start to flake and they'll start to get a little bit sparse in certain areas, which definitely happened to me. I don't know if it happens for everybody, but it definitely happened to me. Certain areas of my brows started to get sparse. It wasn't too many though, just certain little areas, like up here got a little sparse. Right over here got a little sparse too. I ended up filling that in with just like a brow pen, and it was fine. But your brows do start to look a little flaky because they are healing. I just kept putting the ointment on it and just let it be. And then it says day 10 to 5, it's supposed to look like your brows fell out and like they're gone. I haven't had that issue yet. They're definitely lighter than they were when I got them. So I don't know if I'm still in the motions of that, but I haven't had an issue where it looks like they're completely gone. Like, to me, they still look like they're there. Like, all I did was fill in a couple of the sparse areas and brush them up with some clear brow gel, and you could still see the tint in my brows, I feel like. Let me come closer for you guys. Like, you can still see that there's tint going on in there. So personally, I don't feel like they look like they're completely gone, but that is something that could happen depending on how your skin takes to the pigment. Day 15 to day 30, it says that they're going to look like they're back and just be a little bit patchy. I'm not on that day yet, so we'll see how they look when I hit day 15. What my microblading artist did say was that the pigment is going to resurface, so that way you could see it a lot better. So maybe in my sparse areas, the pigment will resurface and we'll be good to go. We'll see when we get to day 15 to 30. and then I'm supposed to touch up in 5 weeks. I've already marked my calendar, so I know when I need to make my touch-up appointment, and I'm actually really excited for that. Not that my brows look crazy or messed up right now, like they still look amazing in my opinion, but I would like to touch up the sparse areas that I could see right now. I mean, I guess we'll have to see within like 15 to 30 days if the pigment resurfaces in those areas, which I'm hoping that they will, but if not, then I'm just gonna get a touch-up anyway, so we'll be fine. We'll be good to go. Another question that I think you guys might have, what topical anesthetics were used? So let me go ahead and show you guys. I know there are some people that have certain allergies to topical anesthetics. I know my mom does. I think she's allergic to like lidocaine. She wanted to get hers done, but I don't think it's a good idea for her because the girl that I went to did use products that have lidocaine in them. So the first numbing agent that she used was this one called Ebonel Numb 520. You guys can look it up online. I'll put a picture of it right here so you could see. The main ingredient in that though is lidocaine. So if you're allergic to that, be mindful of that situation. The next one she used was called Magnum. That one also has lidocaine in it. It has 4% lidocaine, 2% tetracin, and 0.2% epinephrine. So if you're allergic to any of those things, keep that in mind. Maybe see if your microblading artist has anything else that they could possibly use. These are just the ones that mine used. So the second one that I mentioned, the Magnum, is supposed to be a stronger one that acts a little bit faster than that first one. So she used the first one first, and then the one that's a little bit stronger, the Magnum, that's what she used second. After a while, the numbing effect will start to wear off. So I think that's why she used the stronger one second. This way it's a little bit stronger, it acts a little bit faster, and then she could reapply it as necessary and it'll work really quickly. And she didn't have to wait for it to like settle in and everything like she did with the first one. Another question that I think you guys might have is how long does the procedure take? For me, it took about 3.5 hours, almost 3.5 hours, maybe a little bit less than that. So make sure that you give yourself enough time for your appointment because it does take some time to get done, especially if it's your very first appointment. So the second most popular question that I got was how much does it cost? I paid $350 for mine. I believe the touch-up is going to be $100. So it's $350 for the initial and then $100 for the touch-up. I think it varies depending on who you go to, but the girl I went to charged me that. Okay, so for aftercare, what she did was she gave me a couple of these little balms. It's called Skin Candy Modidose Balm. I don't know exactly what's in it, but she gave me this balm to put on. I guess it's like a treatment that you put on. I guess it's like a treatment that you put on before and after. She put this on my brows before I left, and then a few hours later I had to go in and put it on again, and then I put it on again at night. So I put this on my brows twice a day for the first 7 days. She also gave me this cleansing wipe to use on day 7, and that's what I used to completely wipe my brows off, clean them off, get the ointment off of it, and just go about life. So I stopped using this after the 7th day. Oh, another question that I think you guys might have is, can you shower? Can you wash your face? Yes, you can shower. Try not to get like your face wash on. Try not to get your face wash on your brows at first, at least for the first like 7 days. I did my best. Like, I wasn't sitting there scrubbing my brows. I wasn't putting my face under the shower head where it could like impact the brows. I wanted to protect the brows at all cost. I just kind of washed around them and then, you know, washed my eye area, but left my brows alone, and then just went ahead and rinsed my face. That's how I was doing it. And that's probably going to be your best way to go, so you don't ruin anything. Considering how my brows look, I feel like I did okay. And I feel like I didn't really disrupt the process. I kind of just let them be. Okay. So I think those were the main questions that I could come up with and the main questions that I remember being asked on Instagram. If you guys can think of anything else, just let me know in the comments below, and I will definitely keep track of everything and answer them for all of you. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram and thumbs up this video if you liked it and found it helpful. Also, subscribe to my channel if you're new here. Press the bell next to the subscribe button so you can be notified on any new videos that I may post. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one.